Johnny Depp has finally caught a break in the ongoing messy legal battle between him and ex-wife Amber Heard in relation to $7 million of the divorce settlement money that Heard claimed was donated to charity. Allow us to break down the entire Johnny Depp-Amber Heard divorce saga for you in today's video. Don't forget to watch till the end to find the answer to the pressing question as to whether Amber Heard, due to a kind change of heart, willingly let Johnny Depp win the battle. A match made in hell. In 2009, the two A-star actors met on the sets of The Rum Diary, wherein Depp starred as Paul Kemp while Heard played the female lead, Chenault. We assume sparkles flew in the air as Heard made a bold statement to Vogue in 2011 exclaiming, "Working with Johnny was torture. It was better than I ever imagined," which is really saying something. Years on, filing in a court, Heard would be seen claiming that they began dating around the end of 2011 or the start of 2012. Coincidentally enough, it was the same year that Depp and longtime sweetheart Paradis made public their separation after a lengthy 14 years of being together and having two children in the process. While around the same time, Heard also saw a messy breakup with then-partner Tasha Van Rie, wherein reports even made rounds regarding Heard's arrest on grounds of physically assaulting Tasha. Although those charges were then dropped, and even Tasha admitted that the whole thing was over-sensationalized and blown out of proportion by the cops present at the scene. Just 2 years later, reports started flowing in about the alleged engagement of the couple after an image of the actress wearing an ornate ring emerged on the internet. Depp himself kind of gave it away in an interview by discussing marriage planning and also confession to wearing a chick's ring on his finger. "It's probably a dead giveaway, isn't it? Not very subtle," Depp added. And it was. As the two got married in a very secretive private ceremony within their LA home, pictures of which circulated and took over the internet soon after. All hell boils over. Not a marriage destined to last long, Heard filed for divorce just a year later on May 23, 2016 on the grounds of domestic abuse and further got a restraining order against Depp. She alleged that Depp had physically abused her during their relationship and said it was usually while under the influence of drugs or alcohol. She further added that at the time of filing for divorce, an incident had recently occurred in which Depp hurled his phone at her, leaving her face bruised and battered. However, a spokesperson of the local police commented saying an investigation into the domestic incident radio call found that no crime had taken place as Heard had allegedly claimed. While Depp had already been constantly denying these accusations on the premise that it was all an attempt by Heard to secure a premature financial resolution by alleging abuse. Heard had in fact previously testified under oath, but a settlement of $7 million, which Heard received, was eventually reached between the two, wherein she withdrew her request for a domestic violence restraining order, whilst also rescinding her spousal support request of $50,000 per month. According to Heard, she donated the $7 million to charity. The Washington Post op-ed and resulting turmoil. Heard then wrote an op-ed for the Washington Post in which she spoke about the horrible, biased, and unfortunate treatment of women and domestic abuse cases. Heard wrote, "I became a public figure representing domestic abuse, and I felt the full force of our culture's wrath for women who speak out." Although Depp was never mentioned by name in the op-ed, in 2019, Depp sued Heard over the article for $50 million. The suit said that Heard is not a victim of domestic abuse, she is a perpetrator, and deny that Depp ever abused her. Instead, the suit said that Heard's allegations were part of an elaborate hoax to generate positive publicity for the actress. Depp's lawyer said, "The op-ed depended on the central premise that Ms. Heard was a domestic abuse victim and that Mr. Depp perpetrated domestic violence against her." In a court filing that attempted to dismiss Depp's defamation suit, Heard detailed multiple instances of alleged abuse that she said occurred during their marriage and referred to him as the monster, claiming that she still had scars on her body from an incident where Depp allegedly threw her through a ping pong table and dragged her through shreds of broken glass. This suit is still ongoing in the US. The relationship between the two stars and the legal battle continued to become more twisted with a new advancement in allegations every few months, such as the release of phone recordings in 2020, wherein Heard admitted to hitting Depp saying, "I'm sorry sorry that I didn't hit you across the face in a proper slap, but I was hitting you. It was not punching you. Babe, you're not punch. I don't know what the motion of my actual hand was, but you're fine. I did not hurt you. I did not punch you. I was hitting you. Depp, too, was heard admitting to physical abuse between the couple with the words, I left last night. Honestly, I swear to you, because I just couldn't take the idea of more physicality, more physical abuse on each other. Fire to the flame. Infamous libel trial. Johnny Depp's high-profile and ultimately disastrous libel case against The Sun is a rarity in an era where financially struggling news outlets are less willing to fight risky legal cases, and where libel law incentivizes publishers to settle before cases reach court. Depp fought News Group Newspapers, the publisher of The Sun, in court over a 2018 article in which they called him a wife beater in reference to Depp and Heard's former marriage. The trial began in early July and lasted 3 weeks. Depp allegedly said that Heard defecated in his room and threw punches at him, which Heard denies. Accusations of extramarital affairs between Heard with James Franco and Elon Musk, which of course Heard denies, were also hurled by Depp. Heard, meanwhile, accused Depp of domestic abuse, of bruising her face with a phone, and even went to the extent of allegedly claiming that Depp had threatened to kill her. 3 months after the blockbuster trial began, Judge Mr. Justice Nickel ruled that The Sun was correct in reporting that Depp was violent towards his ex-wife, Amber Heard. Johnny Depp has continuously denied all of Heard's claims regarding violence, and in a statement published shortly after the ruling, his lawyers took the stand that this decision is as perverse as it is bewildering. As a further devastating blow to Depp, following his defeat in the libel case, he was thrown out of the movie Fantastic Beasts 3, the news of which Depp announced in a typed letter posted on his gram, which read, I wish to let you know that I have been asked to resign by Warner Brothers from my role as Grindelwald in Fantastic Beasts, and I have respected and agreed to that request. It's no surprise that Johnny Depp's fans were equally sad and enraged at how things played out. Further, when attempts were made in January 2020 by Depp's legal team with an appeal in the hopes to overturn the court's ruling, it was refused by Judge Nickel on the grounds that she did not consider that the proposed grounds of appeal have a reasonable prospect to success. Depp once again submitted an application to the Court of Appeals in London to obtain permission, once more, to contest the High Court ruling, which was again dismissed in March 2020. Heard's role and long-time coming breather for Depp. After some real tough times in the courtroom for embattled actor Johnny Depp, the former Fantastic Beasts 3 star has picked up a rare win in his ongoing legal battle with ex-wife Amber Heard. A New York judge, finally to Depp's relief, has ruled that the American Civil Liberties Union, or ACLU, must provide documentation that confirms whether or not the Aquaman actress gave the nonprofit organization a donation from the $7 million she received in her divorce settlement from the Rum Diaries star, as well as the Children's Hospital Los Angeles, as Depp had claimed from the very beginning that all of the claim of charity was a carefully planned move to build positive publicity. So, from where we see it, Amber Heard in no way whatsoever let Johnny Depp win this case. He battled all failures gracefully and didn't give in until he got some respite. And that's the end of today's video. Subscribe to our channel to not miss out on whatever juicy turn this messy legal saga will take next. If you have anything to add to Johnny Depp's victory, let us know in the comments section below. See you another time!